This is an example of how to use the net change theorem. The question here is a runner runs in a straight line such that their acceleration is a of t equals 2t plus 5 at a time t in meters per second. Find the runner's change in velocity and their change in displacement during the time period t equals 2 to 5. So here we know that t is going to be in seconds. We know this because we're given acceleration here, which is 2t plus 5, and we're also told that the units are meters per second squared. So I'll write that down. So the acceleration is equal to 2t plus 5, and the units are meters per second squared. Since we know that the unit of time here is going to be seconds, we can write down that t is going from 2 to 5 seconds. So here we have to find the runner's change in velocity and their change in displacement. So I'll write down the relationship between acceleration, velocity, and displacement. The integral of acceleration is equal to velocity, and the integral of velocity is equal to position. So now we can start to find our change in velocity. So the formula for change in velocity is from time t1 to t2 of acceleration dt is equal to velocity evaluated time 2 minus velocity evaluated at time 1, because we know that the integral of acceleration is equal to velocity. So we know that our time 2 is going to be 5 seconds, and our time 1 is going to be 2 seconds. So we're going to be integrating from 2 to 5 of 2t plus 5 dt. And now we can start to integrate. So just a reminder, when you integrate x to the n dx, you're going to get x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1, and n cannot equal negative 1. And when you integrate a constant, you're just going to simply multiply it by x. So for the first term, we have 2t. When we integrate, we're going to get 2t squared over 2, which is just t squared. And when we integrate 5, we're just going to get plus 5t. And we're integrating from 2 to 5. And this function right here is the velocity. So we're going to use that for the second part. So we're going to plug in our t2 first. So our 5 is our t2. And our 2 is our t1, so we're going to plug in 5 first. So when we plug in 5, we're going to get 5 squared plus 5 times 5 minus our t1 value plugged in, which is 2. So we're only going to have 2 squared plus 5 times 2. So now if we simplify this, we have 5 squared, which is 25, plus 5 times 5, and 5 times 5 is 25, so here we have 50. And then minus 2 squared is 4, and plus 5 times 2 is 10, so we have minus 14. 50 minus 14 is 36. So units here, as we said, are meters per second. So our therefore statement will be the net change in velocity is 36 meters per second for t equals 2 to 5 seconds. So that's the first part done. So we're done the change in velocity. Now we need to find the change in displacement. So we know that the integral of velocity is going to be our position. So we found here that our function for velocity is t squared plus 5t. So now we're finding the change in displacement. So since we know our velocity is t squared plus 5t, we can integrate in order to get our position. So the formula for this is very similar to the one we used above. It's the integral from t1 to t2 of v of t dt is equal to our position evaluated at time 2 minus our position evaluated at time 1. So now if we plug in our values, we have integral from 2 to 5 of t squared plus 5t dt. And now if we start to integrate, the integral of t squared is 1/3 t cubed. And the integral of 5t is 5t squared over 2. So we have 5 over 2 multiplied by t squared. And we integrate from 2 to 5. So now again, we can start to plug in our values. So again, this is our t2 and this is our t1. And here in the formula, we have to plug in our t2 first. So if we plug in our 5, we're going to get 1/3 5 cubed plus 5 over 2 multiplied by 5 squared. Then we're going to subtract our t1 value plugged in. So we're going to get 1/3 multiplied by 2 cubed plus 5 over 2 squared. And now when we subtract 625 over 6 minus 38 over 3, we're going to get 183 over 2. And that is also equal to 91.5 exactly. And here our units are going to be meters. So we say, therefore, the net change in displacement is 91.5 meters for t equals 2 to 5 seconds. And that is how you use the net change theorem.